It says that I have trained for 551 hours and I have ridden 8,523 miles. I have climbed just a little over 500,000 feet. But yeah, I guess I've been training a lot.
So this year I think I'll hit close to 800 hours of training and somewhere around 17,000 miles of riding by the end of the year.
It's always easy to feel like you're not doing enough, especially in this age of social media. You can kind of see what, you know, the top pros are doing and decide that, oh, that's the only way to be fast. Just keep it fun and simple.
Welcome to Off-Road Bicycle Racers, a motion picture chronicling three stupendous two-wheel riders. Follow along as they take on two contests that ought to make your legs tremble. The Leadville 100, a mountainous marathon where their oxygen generator must be broken, and Steamboat Gravel, a high-velocity pedal contest on gravel that's silky smooth. We hope you enjoy this broadcast.
One of the neat things about doing all these longer races now just means a lot more long days in the saddle. Some days it's a lot of work, but you know, it's kind of my favorite part of it. I feel pretty lucky to be able to just go ride my bike all day and have fun doing it.
I don't like riding my bike for more than 5 hours. Like, I got other things to do. I could hang out with my dog.
Today it's one of the last big rides before Leadville. Took this beautiful climb from Canyon City up to Cripple Creek called Shelf Road. Some really nice scenery back there.
I feel like I've had really good training, but it just hasn't quite clicked. So, you know, pluses and minuses here. But Leadville is definitely one of my favorite races.
Give it up for three-time Leadville winner, Howard Grotts.
This will be my sixth Leadville.
Leadville, it's something that I've always said I never wanted to do in my entire life, and there I was last year attempting to do Leadville. I think I was sick. As I was dying up Columbine, my teammate Russell was running down the hill with a broken rear wheel, and I was able to give him my wheel. He finished top 10, and I had a lovely hike down. Leadville kind of lit a fire in my butt last year. Setting 2023 goals, I said I want to be a better climber. I always like to beat or outdo last year's performance, and since I DNF'd last year, the bar is set so low that I just really want to finish.
Just dig deep out there. Have a safe race. Right smart. We love you. We'll be waiting for you here at the finish line. Here we go in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
The start was really fast. On St. Kevin's climb, I found myself with Alexis, and I was able to ride with her basically all the way to the base of Columbine. And then about halfway Columbine is where I was able to kind of establish a nice little gap on her. I would say 49 of the 50 miles I was by myself, so that was a bit lonely. And with 3 miles to go, Ruth Winder almost caught me, and I managed to put in a little bit of an effort and salvage that first place, because that would have I would have been very heartbroken if I lost Leadville in the last 3 miles. All I had to do to beat last year's result was just finish, so it gave me freedom to really take a big risk in order to try to win. And if I blew up, I blew up, and if somebody was better than me, somebody was going to be better than me. I ended up having a really good Leadville and a little bit unexpected. In these mass start races, as females, you kind of have to learn how to play chess out there, and it's not a head-to-head women's race, so it's a little bit of a bummer, and I do wish that someday we'll have the opportunity of the women having a race that's not impacted by men. Yeah, you just have to be really tactically smart to win these mass start races.
From the gun, it was pretty darn fast. And the main selection came on the climb before the descent down power line.
Felt like I had a pretty good first 20 miles or so. There was kind of like a small group of five of us that rolled away. All kind of came back together on the descent, but unfortunately at the bottom, I kind of realized that I had flatted. Did a quick rear wheel swap. Kind of a rough way to start such a long race. At the end of the day, that's bike racing. Stuff like that happens, and you just got to put your head down and go for it and see what can happen. Slowly chipped guys off throughout the day.
And then on the way back, I felt pretty darn in control. I hit power line. Got a little behind on nutrition going up the pavement climb, and so had to back it off, unfortunately. You know, kind of watch the podium roll away from me there, which was a bit of a bummer.
No matter how you cut it, it's a hard day out there. I feel like I chose kind of the hardest way to do it, just time trialing all day. The last 10 miles, it got pretty eventful. I kind of caught four different guys, and it came down to a four-man sprint, which was a pretty wild and hectic way to end a 6+ hour race, but it was pretty fun. Honestly, I think that was like the highlight of my race, just getting to sprint and go all out. So it's cool to do something like that.
I'm still super happy with how I rode. You know, it was an incredibly tough day. People are so much faster than it seems like they were just last year or a few years before that. So pretty inspiring too.
From my perspective, Leadville was great. It was a bunch of work leading up to the event because the riders wanted such Leadville-specific equipment. So we got them on special tires and special suspension and special shifters on their bars and did everything we could to be strong and lightweight and fast. And it paid off for the most part.
Now that Leadville is done, we get to switch our focus to a gravel race in Steamboat Springs, Colorado, called Steamboat Gravel. 142 miles of what we call champagne gravel, super smooth, fast. We have probably the coolest team around. We're extremely dialed in our equipment. You know, we have Chris Mathis that takes care of our bikes. And then I have two really good teammates. I have Howard that kind of keeps the vibe super chill. He made cookies the other day for fun. I have Finsty, who I've been teammates with for the past 4 years, and whatever he does for equipment, I kind of copy-paste. Sometimes I'll just downsize myself on the chainring, but yeah, I'm just really lucky to have this team that they're a fun group of people to hang out with.
I think we're a really neat blend of athletes. We approach racing very differently. Like with Sofia, she's very focused. Racing is number one, and I really appreciate that attitude. I think it helps me narrow in on race day and just focus on those really important details. Then we have Howie. I think Howie kind of like puts everything into perspective really. Like racing is important, but just having a good experience throughout the weekend is also really important. So sometimes if I'm feeling like I'm getting too stressed or just worrying about the race too much, just kind of hone the Howie approach and calms down a little.
I'm more of a race to train sort of person, where I love the lifestyle that bike racing enables me to live, and I try to do as well as I can. It doesn't always pan out in a win, and then you see someone like Sofia who's just winning, and you know, it's inspiring. But I also see, you know, she puts in a lot to the racing. She does her little like foam roller thing where it's always choof choff, you know, like right on the 30 second mark. I just roll around for like an hour or two. And yeah, Russell also approaches things, you know, he's always tinkering with equipment and setups. I'm learning a ton. Sophia has cooked nearly every meal, you know, that's really nice. I help out by cleaning the dishes, but she has her nutrition plan and she makes the meal, but shares it with all of us, and we are more than happy to help out with the eating.
Steamboat, it's more of a relaxed, like, just kind of enjoyable weekend, very social weekend. The terrain's a little easier. Average speeds are higher. Still signing up for a really big day on Sunday, but at the same time, like just the more relaxed atmosphere here is pretty neat to be a part of. I'm really looking forward to spectating the hill climb tomorrow and seeing what Howie can do out there. I'm expecting some big fireworks.
It'll be hard, but it's short, and I think it'll just be a good atmosphere, a good way to kind of break up the seriousness that these races sort of cultivate.
Have you ever met Miss Lindy? She's a gal with the bright red hair. Our King of the Mountain winner. It's Brian Durango, Howard Grotts!
Good job, Howard.
So Howard Grotts, our champion today.
Went hard, I think, you know, a lot of people went hard, but you can still go hard and have a good time doing it. And costumes, you just can't take yourself too seriously when you're wearing something that looks absurd. So I like that.
Steamboat was my first big mass start gravel race I've ever done, and I got my butt kicked there in 2021, so I really want to come back now that I'm a lot more experienced of a rider and just see what I can do.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, let's go!
The start was really fast. That was really lame. Alexis and I found ourselves in a really nice group of men, and then her and I worked really well together and first 100 miles together. Thought we had like 10 minutes, and then all of a sudden we're down to like a minute 45, and I put in an effort.
This town ain't big enough for the two of us.
Rode my own pace. Took a big risk, and it paid off. Pretty pumped. I definitely targeted Steamboat. It was definitely one that I really wanted to have a good performance at, regardless of what that result would be. I'm proud of myself. Like, I worked really, really hard.
Let's give it up for our women's podium, Sofia Villafane.
Pretty early on, like a selection of 5 or so riders was made, and Russell and I just missed that. Worked pretty hard to keep him close. Burned some matches early on. Attacks started coming. I just didn't quite have it.
With like 50 miles to go, the lights just went out. Like, I had absolutely nothing left in me. I was literally pedaling at 180 watts and seriously questioning how I was going to do 50 miles to get home. It just seemed like a very daunting task there for a little while. Pretty stoked to see Sofia conquer both these races over the last 2 weeks.
I'm having a good year, and I'm having a lot of fun and super thankful for my team. It's just really nice and special to kind of see it all come together in such a big way this year.